Nobody can give a better speech, and nobody can make a better argument, and nobody can present something more lovingly than the Prophet himself, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is the best teacher for all of humanity. So Abu Talib had the best teacher with the best message and the best opportunity to learn this message. There was nothing missing. Everything that could be done was being done. And yet he's still not listening. And so this pain that maybe the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, what did he do wrong? What's missing? Why won't he just accept? And so Allah told the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam something very heavy that I want you to really think about today. And that's the words of Allah when Abu Talib passed away. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. You certainly are not the one who guides whoever you love. You're not in charge of guiding whoever you love. Now, I love my children. You can love your spouse. You can love your parents. You can love your brother or your sister. We have love for family. The Prophet ﷺ's love can never be compared. The kind of love he had, the kind of heart, we can never compare. And that love makes you want the best things for the person you love. Which is why the Prophet ﷺ wants guidance for Abu Talib. That's the best thing you can have. The ultimate gift would be guidance. And Allah has given the ultimate gift of guidance to the Messenger ﷺ. And his loving uncle didn't take it. He didn't take this profound gift. It's so painful. And Allah taught him a very heavy reality. And through that painful experience of the Prophet ﷺ, he taught us a reality. You, for sure, are not the one who guides whoever you love. You know, every time we read about the Prophet ﷺ and something painful that he went through, you have to understand something. Allah put him through trials and difficult experiences, not because Allah wants him to go through difficult experiences. Allah loves him more than anyone else. This is the most beloved creation of Allah. So you have to ask yourself, why is Allah putting his messenger through these painful experiences? Because he is rahmatan lil alameen. Because he's a mercy and a teacher and a care and an act of love from Allah for all people forever to come. In other words, you and I are going to have people that we love. You and I are going to have people in our life that we want to see guided, that we want to see change, and we're not going to see them change no matter what we do. And it's going to be frustrating. What are we supposed to do? I've tried everything. I've tried speaking softly. I've tried gently reminding. I've tried this and I've tried that and I've tried the other. Nothing's working. I don't know what to do. They seem to be getting even further away. And it is in these moments that we have to remind ourselves of the exact same pain that the Prophet ﷺ felt at people like his uncle. And by the way, it's not even limited to his uncle. In the Arabic language, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ, this is called al-a'id, al-damir al-a'id in grammar. So the expected language is إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ هُ. There's a damir expected. But there's a hathful damir, there's a pronoun missing. And what that does is that the ayah is not even limited to the uncle of the Prophet ﷺ. The